In this tutorial, we are going to create this animation. You can download this Procreate file or draw your own vehicle and character. Just keep in mind that the wheels have to be on a separate layer, okay? So, having said that, let's create a new layer and place it here. This will be just a reference layer. It will represent the canvas size of our final animation. You will understand what I am talking about in a moment. Let's turn it pink, for example, and let's choose this color for our background. Now we are going to resize our image to create our animation. I will triple its width, but you can double it instead or make it even longer. Now, duplicate your canvas layer and place it at the end of the canvas. We are going to make a looping animation, so everything we draw in here has to be in here too. And we can draw whatever we want in the middle, okay? Let's start creating a bumpy road. New layer. Bumpy road. Choose a dark gray color, download the cartoon stamp set of brushes and select the bumpy road brush. Make a line, a straight line, and let's fill the road with the same gray color. Move the layer above the wheels and create a new layer below them. We are going to draw the background. Let's start making some brushes. To make this process faster, I've created a few stamps. Let's choose this one, for example. I will move it a little bit up. Select a different one. And I will move it up again. There. Okay. Let's turn off the visibility of these layers so we can see the whole bushes. Zoom in, turn on alpha lock, and let's add a bit of texture and different colors to these stamps. I need to choose a nice gray color to paint the small stones. Now choose a nice brush and let's paint. Choose the dark color, change the brush if you want to, and let's add some shadow areas. Light areas. And let's paint a few yellow flowers now. Using the same technique, add highlights, shadows, and a bit of texture to the rest of the bushes. Once you're done, let's stamp some clouds. Cloud number 3 in white. Don't forget to turn off alpha lock, okay? Cloud number two. Well, let's use the number one. Now we are going to duplicate our background layer, because, as we said before, everything that is here should be also here. I will use a small point technique to place the drawings exactly where they have to be. But maybe it would have been easier just to make a group with the background on the pink layer, duplicate that group, and move it to the end of the canvas. Well, do it as you prefer, okay? Merge the background layers and let's create a few more bushes and clouds in the middle. Once you're done, turn on the visibility of all the layers. Let's turn off alpha lock and make a group with all the layers but the canvas ones. To create the animation easily, we are going to go to Actions, Canvas and turn on Drawing Guide. Now tap on Edit Drawing Guide and increase or decrease the grid size until you fit 4 squares in one of our pink squares. Okay? Don't forget to tap Done. Open the Layers panel and duplicate the group. Select the background and the bumpy road layers. Tap Transform. We are going to move them to this line. Okay? Duplicate the group again. Select the same layers and move them to the next line. Repeat the process until you get to the line that is closest to the other pink square. We don't need to duplicate more groups because the next one will be the same image as the first one. Next step, go to Crop and Resize and let's come back to the original canvas size. Now let's delete the pink layers. We no longer need them. And it's time to see how our animation is looking. Tap Animated GIF. The frames per second look about right to me. So let's export the animation. Okay, our background looks nice, but the motorcycle looks like it is sliding, right? Let's make it bounce a little bit. This step is super easy. We just have to select every other girl and motorcycle layer. So let's select this one, leave this one, select this one, and so on. Now tap Transform and move them a little bit up. Let's see how it's looking now. Much better, right?